Here's Seahawks kicker Norm Johnson for B&B Used Cars.
Hi, I'm Seahawks kicker Norm Johnson for B&B Used Cars. We've got some great deals right now, so come on down and kick a tire.
Norm, it's okay. It's okay. We'll do another one, huh? All right? Norm kicks, take 55.
Tonight on Almost Live, Bill Nye the Science Guy delves into areas beyond the range of human understanding. He tampers with things man was meant to leave alone. He plays God. Do not attempt this at home. And now, here he is.
John.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Well, you know, it's such an exciting time tonight. Cincinnati, just a few minutes ago, has won the World Series in four straight games. How about it for Cincinnati? Yeah. And I've got a personal message to Pete Rose. Pete, if you had any money down in the prison pool, I really hope you bet on the old home team. Hope you got some cigarettes or something out of that. Anyway, speaking of money, the big news in Seattle this week, Boeing, plane maker to the world, got an order for the new model 777 that's worth $11 billion. And you know what that means? There's going to be layoffs. So, you know. Actually, Boeing is going to spend those billions in really good ways. For starters, new plaid thermoses for every employee. They're going to buy some really good snack machines for the factories. They're going to provide carrying cases for those employee ID badges so they're not, you know how those Boeing guys always have them hanging from their jackets every damn place they go? That's gone. And they're going to put really cool racing stripes on all the planes. So I think that's really going to improve the employee morale down there at the Lazy Bee. But, you know, this big order, it wasn't a fluke. You know, the airlines, they like the new 777 because it's so technologically advanced, and we've obtained a list of some of the new features, and I have to say it's pretty impressive. Look at the technological advances. A Gabby pilot mute button, which is great. Each plane is going to have a trailer hitch for slower Douglas planes. They're going to have dinner entrees that don't bounce. Bell cords that you pull to tell the pilot you want to get off at the next stop, which is good. That's good. In addition to the flight deck, there's going to be a flight patio with a baby Weber. And best of all, instead of a flotation device, your seat cushion turns into a bottle of vodka. So once again, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for that validation. Once again, Boeing is setting the standards in the air transportation business, but when it comes to transportation on the road, few companies can rival the services of this establishment.
And now, with a special message from the Ballard Driving Academy, here's Orly Torgerson.
Here at the Ballard Driving Academy, for over 35 years, we've been teaching people to drive just like they live in Ballard.
Welcome to the Ballard Driving Academy.
Thank you.
All right, now before we start, please adjust your seatbelt. Okay, good. Now check your left turn signal. Okay, now leave that on all day. Make sure that never goes off.
Okay.
All right? Everything seems to check out. Right, let's go into traffic. Whoa, where's the fire?
What?
Well, how fast are you going?
10.
Now bring it down to 7. So there you go. That's as fast as we go in Ballard.
Okay.
Now let me see how many cars you're holding up. 6, 7.
8.
All right, 8 cars. You passed. You're not using the whole road.
What?
You pay taxes on the whole road, don't you?
Right.
Well,
yeah.
Use the whole road. Weave. There you go. Weave.
Yeah.
Keep it to 7 miles an hour. Just weave. Yeah.
Okay.
Switch lanes at random. Don't let them see what you're doing. That's it. Just keep weaving. That's good. How long you lived in Ballard?
All my life.
How long you want to live here?
Till I die.
All right. Okay, pull over here and let's try some parallel parking.
Okay.
All right. No, don't look back.
What?
Do it by sound.
What do you mean?
Do it by sound. There, okay. That's far enough. Now go ahead and go forward. Now don't look. There. Right. Perfect.
Good.
That's the Ballard way. That's good.
At the Ballard Driving Academy, you'll also learn these useful skills. Using curbs to steer, getting stuck on median dividers, new looks in hats, how to argue with paramedics, stopping 20 feet before the intersection, then lurching forward, turning right, no, wait a minute, stop!
Bob, you've passed all your tests, so you've earned the sticker. Keep it on your car at all times. That means you're a Ballard driver. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Wouldn't you like to be a Ballard driver, too? Come see us today.
All right, stay with us. We'll be right back with Bill Nye, the Science Guy. We're back.
You know, there's a sense of nervous anticipation in the studio tonight, and I they're really nervous, you can tell. And that can mean only one thing. It's time to bring on once again a great humanitarian, a great entertainer, and my personal friend for over 35 years. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Nye, the Science Guy. Feel great, Bill. They
yeah.
love to see you. Doesn't
yeah.
that feel great?
It's cool.
You yeah. know, we all feel great today. The crew's been telling me today. Everybody's telling me this is the science guy to end all science guys. That could mean it's either really dangerous or really cool, but I know there's a lot of really neat apparatus in the studio that I can see.
It's really cool.
It looks really neat. So why don't we get to it?
Let's do that, John.
What are we getting? What is it tonight? What's the theme?
I'm so happy you asked. Vortices, if I may say.
Vortices.
Over here,
okay.
please. To the official size and weight, almost live vortex generator.
Looks like, to all, you know, it looks like an ordinary trash can to me, Bill.
Oh, John.
I guess it is,
in a way. Yeah, but this is actually a precision instrument that generates puffs of air and vortex rings, which I'll show you. Now, just may I take a moment and make sure we're cool here. Yes, there
okay.
we go. Now, John?
Yeah.
Your
yeah.
task shall be
okay,
to strike... This plastic membrane stretched over the surface of the vortex generator, reed trash
right.
can,
mm-hmm.
and that will create these puffs of air, which will put out, if I may, these candles.
It can't be done.
Oh, yes, John. Oh, yes, don't
That's
be skeptical.
That's too far away. I'm
oh,
Bill,
yes.
I have to say, I'm skeptical. This is going to be really impressive. If
yeah,
you
now look, how far away this guy is. He's way over there.
All right, so you're telling me if I hit this...
Oh, yeah, tell you what, can you move the orange door a little out of the way there? In the
oh,
front,
okay.
Yeah, just pry
the orange
it,
door.
Just force
okay.
it. Yeah, there you go.
Okay,
thank
good. Me. Glad you...
All right, John, a puff of air, if you would. A vortex
right.
coming my way.
Okay, let's see. Okay.
Ah, a little
oh,
harder, John.
It made it down. Let me try it one more time
Please.
Here, Bill. Whoa!
Tell you what, John, turn it just a little that
just
way.
Just a little, yeah. All right. Phaser is locked on
there
here. Okay, we got it. Okay, Mr. Sulu. Here we go. Oh!
Okay, John.
It's
John,
one
John.
Of those fake candles. It's one of the,
no, just a little over this way, I think. Now. Okay, John.
Okay.
Yeah, well, this is live television.
Like I said, the
we
crew
really
was
have
really.
Fun here.
Like I said, the crew was
Let's
really
tighten
excited.
This up. This is really cool. Boy, this works every time, John.
I gotta believe this probably worked really good at one time.
Boy, that is just bugging me. Well, John.
Ladies and gentlemen.
There.
Yeah. He did it. Whoa. Bill, I'll tell you. It was nail-biting time for a bit there, but boy.
Now, John.
Snuffed the candle from across the room. That was
tell
really,
you what we're gonna do now.
The vortex generator, ladies and gentlemen.
What we're going to do...
You can build one in your own home.
We're going to fill the official... now it's aimed. Can I say
right.
now it's aimed? We'll fill the Almost Live Vortex Generator with Hollywood fog.
Okay.
Hollywood fog, which
well,
we have here...
How is that different than, say, Bellevue fog? Or,
oh, it's much more expensive even than Bellevue fog, John.
I hope it's... smells like Tacoma fog.
Yeah,
so, I don't know.
Maybe it's a combo. Okay, now, John, it's full.
Okay.
Now, if you would now gently puff me a vortex.
Well, I'm not going to blow anything out.
No, no, just gently puff a vortex for the folks at home.
All right. Ooh! Oh, yeah.
Well, John, tell you what.
Smoke rings.
Hit camera one there. Can we lower camera
one? Okay, we're going after camera one. Let's see.
Let me give you a little pump.
Is this in the warranty? Wow! Wait. Okay.
Gently, John.
Okay, let's see. Oh, yeah, let's see. It's like the smoke ring thing, the sign, like in New York, that the lucky strike. Well, what's happening?
Nothing, Gil? John. It's just getting a lot of use in the panic.
Okay.
All right, John, that's great. You're puffing away. Now you can get like rings inside of rings and stuff. Now I'm going to re-energize the candle.
Okay, there. See, I'm getting some good rings there.
Yeah, now we can see. We can track. It's like the tracer weapons in World War II.
I guess they still have those, Bill. Yeah, I think this is how we defeated the Nazis. Yeah.
Well, we didn't have.
Yeah, okay.
John, we didn't have high molecular weight polyethylene in those days. Don't be silly.
Okay.
Okay, John, puff me.
Well, that's not going to. All right, Bill. I'm puffing Bill now. There.
Now, you see that? You see how much the barrier moves? But does the candle go out? No, the candle doesn't go out. But, John, when I put on these fairings made of the very finest...
That's a fairing?
Is that
what that is?
A hemispherical fairing made of the very finest United States styrofoam.
Yeah.
What will happen due to the forces of Bernoulli, the air will be forced around the ball...
And this is the Bernoulli effect. Is that
this would be part of it. Would be related, but it's also you see vortex rings and the Bernoulli effect. It's a big aerodynamic
party. So there's some scientist named Bernoulli who this is his life's work.
Let's go, John.
Cannon?
Let's go. They're waving to us. Harder,
okay.
John.
All right.
More power. John, we're counting on you. Yes!
Unbelievable.
Stand here.
Bill. How?
John.
How can we top this?
You may ask.
How can we top this, John?
What can we do with this? How can we harness this wonderful power, indeed?
My question exactly.
The power of air, the power of vortices, the power of rings, of annuli, of air. Let me show you.
Of annuli.
That
was Bernoulli. This is annuli.
If you like annuli.
Oh, now look, see what this is. This is a air hockey puck.
It's the blue disc of excitement.
All right. Looks
Please have a seat, John.
Looks very much like an air hockey puck. Of a, say, the mid-70s game parlor or the finer taverns in the Seattle area.
Yeah, but you had more hair then, didn't you?
That's true, I did.
I don't know. Okay, now, look. What we got here, the lovely Chris, our production assistant, and I will now play catch with John on the aerodynamically supported hovercraft.
Let's see. Oh, my goodness. Well, this is it. Bill, this is spectacular. Ladies and gentlemen, Bill Nye, the science guy. Let's hear it.
Studio amplification for Almost Live provided by American Music. And now, it's time for the Johnson Family News with anchorpersons Ralph Johnson and Karen Johnson. Sports with Bucky Johnson and Beth Johnson with the weather. This is the Johnson Family News.
Good evening. I'm Ralph Johnson. In tonight's top story, after 15 years of marriage, Ralph and Karen Johnson are calling it quits. The couple will file for divorce, and Ralph Johnson will move out of the house next week. He'll move in with his 22-year-old blonde secretary from down at Johnson Construction, Chelsea Fox. We'll have more on that story as it develops. Karen, over to you.
Thanks, Ralph. In a related story, we have a report of a freak accident downtown. Let's go to my brother Bill Davis at the scene.
Thank you, Karen. I'm here at the scene on Route 99 where investigators are calling it one of the weirdest accidents they've seen in a long time. A white Mazda Miata lost all four of its wheels simultaneously and skidded into the concrete barrier. The driver, 22-year-old Johnson Construction Secretary Chelsea Fox, has been rushed to Central Hospital, where she's expected to require some plastic surgery.
The investigators do not suspect sabotage. Back to you, Karen.
Thanks, Bill. What a strange accident. We have a correction to one of the stories reported earlier. Ralph Johnson will be moving out of his house tonight, not next week, as reported. Now, let's go to sports and see what's happening with Bucky Johnson.
Thanks, Mom. Well, the Johnson Construction American Legion baseball team lost another heartbreaker, 6-5 to Acme Market. For the second week in a row, poor managing by Ralph Johnson cost the team, said losing pitcher Jason Kent. Old man Johnson sucks. Back to you guys.
Thanks, honey. As we welcome the fall season, the weather is, as usual, unpredictable in the Johnson household. Let's check in with Beth.
Well, it's another typical weather day inside the Johnson house, roasting downstairs and freezing cold here in my room. And it's gonna stay that way till Ralph Johnson fixes his stupid wood stove. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Pumpkin. When we return, we're going to have a story about a local woman who neglects the welfare of her children and her family.
Actually, Ralph, that story has been preempted. Stay tuned immediately for a 3-hour special titled Ralph Johnson, the Tyrant Behind the Phony Exterior.
Oh, come on.
Good night.
Look, I was only...
Bye, Ralph.
Welcome to the John Report. I'm John. Here's my report. A man was sentenced to 180 days in jail for driving a locomotive from the Seattle waterfront to Tukwila. The judge gave him the maximum sentence, saying any man who preferred Tukwila to the Seattle waterfront should be considered confused and dangerous. Several Northwest Airlines jets were grounded this week when a mechanic confused liquid soap with hydraulic fluid. An airline spokesman said that while soap in the hydraulic system was certainly a problem, the real complaints came from the washroom, where passengers couldn't stop moving their hands up and down. Last week, Hanford workers had to bury hundreds of radioactive dogs. There was some confusion at first because the workers thought, hey, for Tri-Cities, these dogs look pretty good. A study shows that 90% of Seattle drivers don't stop or slow down for pedestrians in crosswalks. On the positive side, 50% said they would pull over if the pedestrian became tangled in the drive shaft. A rap concert in Longview has been okayed despite criticism of the violent and pornographic lyrics. Protesters said that they prefer country western music and its family-oriented songs about drunken brawls and sex with strangers in the back of pickup trucks. Cedar Hill's landfill near Issaquah has started offering public tours. It's already outdrawing other favorite attractions in the area, such as the Tukwila Slaughterhouse and the Tumwater Cesspools. Cesspools. A new study says that tractor pulls may be hazardous to your health because of the large amounts of carbon monoxide. All residents of the city of Puyallup are advised to consult their doctors. And finally, Boeing workers say that a pilot program for a 4-day work week is going very well, and they hope it will continue. A management spokesperson expressed surprise, saying that the pilot program doesn't start until next year. This has been the John Report. Thank you.
It seems strange that here in the great Northwest, people are drinking fancy European bottled waters, when in our own home state, we have a sparkling water that's every bit as great as those European drinks. Hanford Sparkling Water. Made from mysterious sources deep beneath the Tri-Cities, Northwesterners are quickly making Hanford the drink of choice in any situation.
I serve Hanford water to all my upscale friends.
Hanford, a heavy water with a light taste.
That's Hanford, right? Oh, there's Hanford there. Thank you. Well, gosh, that's just about all we have time for tonight. If you're worried at home, Bill Nye, he got the defibrillator. The what was it, Bill? The Vortex generator. Everything's fine. You can make those at home if you want to just sort of cut up your recycling bins. It'll be really fun. Don't try that at home. Anyway, we're going to be back next week welcoming comedian Carrie Snow. She'll be on the show. You can also see her, I think, all week at the Comedy Underground, which will be really exciting. And we want to say thanks again. Good luck to Pete in prison, wherever you are. Once again, we really hope you made some money off your home team tonight. We'll be going to Saturday Night Live in a minute, and we hope we see you here. Oh, for tickets, call Princess Clarissa at 448. That's Princess. She's a legitimate princess. Call her that when you call 448-3795 during regular business hours. We'll see you next week. Thanks, and bye-bye.
Promotional considerations are almost live, provided by Pizzeria Pagliacci, featuring traditional and gourmet pizza by the slice. Pizzeria Pagliacci, rated Seattle's best pizza.